Really?
Not filming. Oh, there it is. Yep.
Live from the Grapevine. This is the Kosher Wine Review. I'm Yehuda Shuhworth. And today we are pumping out of a little tool called the Corkman. It opens it, but doesn't open it. It pours it without pouring it. And this is the 2009 Chateau Tetre d'Ogai. It's a Saint-Emilion Grand Cru, again from 2009. If you know anything about 2009, 2010, they're some of the greatest vintages in Bordeaux history. This is 14.5% alcohol, and of course the greatest 80% Merlot, 20% Cabernet Franc, in a Saint-Emilion and Pomerol style. So let's pour this through here, our little aerator guy. First thing I'm going to do is pour just a little peensy bit down the shaft just to clean it off. As weird as that may seem, if you don't do that, then you're going to get not the quality wine that you need. And yes, I am aerating this wine because I think it really needs about 6 hours to breathe. So I have my setting at 6 hours, but let's see if it's going anywhere. Yes. Now, I'm going to do a double. I'm going to do a triple. It's fascinating, this little tool. It opens wine, but it doesn't open the wine. Notice nothing else is coming out, except for a few drops. It is leaving an inert gas. Okay, let's give this a smell with one aerate pour through and three. First of all, there's an incredible amount of concentration and fruit in a restricted fashion. What I mean by that, it's not some fruit bomb that's jumping out ready to clobber you across the face, but it is not sleepy like a Pinot Noir or some subdued grape without a lot of expression coming out of the nose. Mix them up, right? I'll run through the aerator one time. This wine shows a very good crossbreed of darker and red fruits. I love when I get this like strawberry seed characteristic is one of my favorite things I look for. There's definitely some earthiness in a big way on this wine. It's got some green characteristics, but the fruit is really, really powerful. But again, not like whoa in your face. It just it's present and concentrated. If someone was to do a mash down of a bunch of berries, but have an opening of the chamber only a little bit. This is the kind of thing I'm talking about. It's not jammy per se. It's not like explosive. It's just really intense and present. Very cool. Even some like prickly citrus fruit thing. No, not really tropical. Only the skin of it. It's not going citrus. It's not going into like Asian herbs at all. Very interesting wine to smell. Let's taste these back to back. Right, really softens up with some air. Six years ago this wine was harvested. So needs to sit on its rear end for a little bit longer. Yet at the same time, the quality of the wine, the legs coming off this wine would show the structure of the wine. The feel in your palate is really a delight. This is an excellent, mature person's wine who can sit back and chew on and think about a wine. It's not going to hammer you across the head. It's got beautiful darker fruit, again with that little kind of cherry, strawberry seed, good acid. the tannins and the fruit and the acid are so well balanced. And again, it's a very young wine, even though it's 6 years past harvest. Let's taste the one that was open a lot longer. Softer still. Much more expression in the length of the finish of the fruit when it gets to air out for a while. If you're going to drink this wine today, the 2009 Chateau Tetreg d'Ogay Saint Emilion Grand Cru, if you're going to drink this now, decant the wine for at least 3 hours. Let it sit out there, give it a little paper towel or something so no bugs get up in it, but it'll still get some air exchange. I think you'll be extremely pleased. It is a gorgeous wine. Again, the greatest wines for me are not the ones necessarily for food. This is a wine, you have a baguette, some olive oil, you dip it, you drink, you bite. You dip it, you drink, you bite. Remember, close our eyes to smell, open our eyes to drink. L'chaim v'bracha, I'm Yehoshua Wirth, live the grapevine. This is the Kosher Wine Review.